Yo, what is up, everyone? We're back here at Get Jacked on Ark Survival Evolved. And I did a guide in the past when the babies first came out on how to do all the dino breeding, mating, all that kind of stuff. Now, a lot of things have changed and things we've just learned a lot more. So, I'm going to be doing a full guide on mammal and egg-laying dinosaur breeding. And I'm just going to get into all the details on how it goes. And we're going to breed up a couple of... We're going to breed up three total dinosaurs here just to kind of show how it all works. So, I'm going to go in here, and first thing you're going to do is this is with egg-laying dinosaurs. Now, I use a pen for some, but for birds and that kind of stuff, you're definitely just going to have to do this. Now, what you can do is you don't have to build a pen or anything like that, is you can actually enable wandering. Now, I'm going to enable wandering, and I'm going to enable wandering here. And now, if you just keep spamming... He's moving right now, but if you're actually spamming your stop key, all stop, which is actually U, they're going to stop, and as you can see, the mating progress is going up. So you actually don't have to do a pen or anything like this. Now, I know a lot of you know how to do, got to make sure we get that one, and you do have to whistle it at each of them, or you can do all stop, but that's what we're going to do with them. I actually just did an Argent one a little bit ago, so we're actually not going to use an Argent egg. We're going to do a couple other eggs. So we'll get into the eggs now. Now, this mating progress is obviously just going to go up all the way to the top until they lay an egg. So that's pretty much how that works. So I'm going to disable wandering on them, and then we're going to get into the egg-laying process and kind of how to hatch those eggs and everything else. Alright, so here we are, and I've picked out two eggs kind of for a certain purpose. Now, I've got a Bronto egg, and I've got two of our Compi eggs. Now, the Bronto is actually the biggest dinosaur in the game, and the Compis are the smallest, so I thought it'd be funny to actually do those together. Now, if you look at the incubation time, once you've gotten your egg, you're just going to want to put it in a certain spot. Now, this spot, as you can see, I've got a ramp and then four ceilings. Now, those four ceilings... have four air conditioners underneath them, so any egg under any situation can go under here. So I'm going to leave those eggs for a second as they incubate, so we can just give a little time to show kind of how the bar lowers. I'll grab a drink of water here and then go back. So those air conditioners are going to keep the temperature nice and stable so that we don't have to worry about all that kind of stuff, and we don't have to worry about switching it between a heat source and a air conditioner. Yeah, let's give it a little bit more time. I'll go grab this little obelisk right here. Or supply crate. Oh, okay. An apprentice scorpion saddle. That's not too bad. Alright, so that should be enough time to show a little difference in it. Now, the Bronto egg takes a lot longer to incubate than the Compi egg. And all of them kind of differ, and they all differ in temperature too. Which is why the air conditioner way is the best way to go. Because it will regulate the temperature to exactly what they need to be. So, we've got our eggs going here. And I'll just take one more look at them as we go. So they're incubating. This one is about there. And then these ones are now pretty close to done. So those ones don't take too long at all. So, now I'm going to get into actually the dinosaurs. So... Now, they've both hatched, and when they hatch, you're going to get your babies, and check out this baby Bronto. It is hilarious. Look at how cute he is. He's got, like, no tail. His tail's so tiny. Okay, so when you've got your babies, you're going to want to start to pump food into them, and their weight will slowly go up over time. Now, let's see if we can find the other one. Do you see him? This is called Search for the Baby Compi. See if you can find him before I can. They are literally the smallest little thing ever. And here he is. Look at this guy. He is so tiny. You can barely even see him. But he's growing. Now he's going to take meat. And as they grow, he started with only being able to take 4 meat. And then his weight slowly will rise. And you'll just keep adding meat as you go to them. So that's kind of how the process works. As for the Bronto... That one is really, really simple because he's going to take tons and tons of berries. Look at his weight compared. These hatched at exactly the same time, and his weight is so much higher just because it scales based on a percentage. So, he's able to hold a lot, so I don't have to worry about him. The Compi, I do have to keep going back and forth feeding just in case because we don't want to lose this little guy after all this effort. so we'll add a little bit more meat into them. And now we're going to get into the actual mammal part. So those were both egg ones. One was a herbivore and one was a carnivore. So we've got both of them, and now I'm going to head over and show you how mammals work. So a mammal is going to have it inside. It's not going to have an egg or anything. So I've got two direwolves in here. Now they're mammals, and they're going to lay, or they're going to actually go through the whole process like humans of having a baby. So we're going to enable wandering on both of these, and I've got them caged up because they're not going to go anywhere, and this is going to make it super simple, and I can just leave them and not have to worry about a thing. So I'm going to shut them in there. And this is just like what I showed you with the birds, just with a cage. You can also do the whistle technique here, but sometimes I don't like to sit there and whistle and whistle and whistle, so it's kind of nice to just have a little cage all set for them. And now if I go up to our girl here, oh, the high level one here, you will actually see that, but I can actually check it through the cage, which is actually really convenient as well. So there we are. And it doesn't take too long. This is actually probably the quickest bar that you're going to get the mating progress. So I'm going to go ahead with this until it is ready to actually get impregnated. So she is really close. She's just about to. Just a couple more ticks of the bar here. And it didn't take too long at all. It was probably only a few minutes. And there she goes. Now I think they both roar. They both roar together, and that is, she has now become pregnant. And they didn't start moving until very close to the end, so they just wanted to frustrate me at the end there. So now I'm going to pop out our girl here. We'll bring her over to the other one so that we can kind of go over this. But I should probably, before we get into that, let's go check and see how our little compy is doing. Because we don't want to let him run out of food. How much food you got there, buddy? Only a few. Let's load you back up. Okay. So he's all good, and now we're going to bring her over here and then go along with the gestation period, which is going to actually come along with the mammals. So open this up, and we'll grab you out. We'll turn them off wandering. We don't want to forget them on wandering because they'll end up somewhere else. Come here, you. Disable wandering. Did that work? What? Oh, no. Gotta go into its inventory here. Okay, it did work, so now we can just ride it over. And as it is having the baby and whatnot, the dire wolves don't need saddles at all, but you can actually ride them around nice and safe. You don't have to worry about anything. If you're worried about it popping out and you're out somewhere else, you can just bring it with you. So I'm gonna put her right next to these guys so that the baby comes out and has these guys to hang out with. So now, like I said, it does have the gestation bar. Now, that's like the one that takes the most, because you're going to have to go through that period, and then you're going to have to go through this whole baby period again. Now, the whole thing that you're going to want to aim for is the juvenile stage. Now, at the juvenile stage, as you can see now, there's no feeding trough icon above their heads, even though there's a feeding trough near, and that's because they're babies. When they reach that juvenile stage, they're actually going to get the feeding trough, as you can see above her head, and they'll be able to eat out of the trough. So you'll only need to make it to about 15% where the juvenile state starts, and then you can just feed up troughs and leave it overnight or something like that, and it shouldn't be too bad. Alright, and then I'm just coming in, and it's just, oh, there it is, actually, it just came out. Look at him. Oh, look at how cute he is. Oh my gosh, it's just a little dire wolf, and she just got done with that period, so now I have to go through the baby part again with this little guy. And check him out, we're gonna throw meat into him. So the baby process just takes a little bit more time, I think, than actually hatching an egg or something like that. So we've got these, throw in some meat, nope, that's all we can do. Little guy, alright. So we've got our dire wolf, we've got our bronto, and we've got our compy, which is awesome. Now we just have to keep feeding them. Alright, so now in the daylight, check out this little guy. We've also reached the juvenile stage on my other guys. So they're actually eating out of feeding trough, so I don't have to worry about anything too much. This guy's still a baby, but this he can actually hold a ton of meat for how little he is, which is actually great. See, now this is a juvenile Bronto. It's a little bit bigger, but it'll say juvenile in front of it. And now I've filled it up with berries, but I've also filled up the trough nearby with berries, just in case. Alright, so we'll finish putting in the meat. It shouldn't be too hard from here on out. See, now I've just got them in the trough as well, where they can eat out of that. And soon the dire wolf will be eating out of the trough, so it should be nice and simple to get these raised up. So that's pretty much all you have to do. It's a lot easier knowing all these little tricks to the trade instead of just having to go at it with just breeding like normal. We've definitely been able to figure out a lot of things after all of the updates to the breeding system. Alright, and that's pretty much all I have for you today. We've got our little compi, he is full grown, and we've got our direwolf and Bronto. Look at how massive that Bronto is. And this is actually the first Bronto that we have, so I can actually play around a lot with that. Let's throw you in there with the rest of your friends. And no, that was great. I hope you liked the video with all the different kinds of breeding, and even if you know all about the breeding, I hope you like the little babies and all that kind of stuff. Other than that, that's pretty much all I have for you today. If you liked the video, please hit that thumbs up or subscribe to the channel for more content. Thanks a lot for viewing all the videos and really helping out and subscribing to the channel, everyone. I really appreciate it. Otherwise, have a great rest of your day, and we will catch you next time.